Hello everyone. Today we're going to be taking notes on operations with decimals. So you need to title your notes first. So go ahead and write operations with decimals as your title. Now you need to write down adding and subtracting with decimals. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to give you the steps that you're going to follow in order to solve these problems. So you need to write down steps. So the first step that you're going to write is line up the decimal points. The second step, fill in any empty spots with zeros. Okay, the third step add or subtract just like you were adding or subtracting whole numbers. Add or subtract just like you were adding or subtracting whole numbers. And remember, these steps are for both adding and subtracting decimals. The fourth step is going to be bring down the decimal. So your example is going to be a subtraction example. You're going to do 94 2/10 minus 15 77/100. when you're given a math problem that's written horizontally, you need to rewrite it vertically. So that's what we're going to do. Remember to fill in any empty spots with zeros, and then we're going to solve our problem. Okay, next guys, you're going to write down multiplying decimals. You're also going to write down the steps to solving multiplying decimals. So right after you write that down, you're going to write steps. So step one, put the number with the most digits on top. And remember, decimals do not need to be lined up. So put the number with the most digits on top. And I also want you to write, decimals do not need to be lined up. So the second step, multiply like normal. So when you're solving problems with decimals and you're multiplying, you're going to multiply like normal, like you would if you had whole numbers. So step two is just multiply like normal. Step three, count how many places are behind the decimal in both numbers. Number four, from the right side of the product, move the decimal to the left the same amount of spaces. From the right side of the product, move the decimal to the left the same amount of spaces. Okay, our example is going to be 25 and 82 hundredths multiplied by 14 and 3 tenths. And again, we're going to rewrite our problem. We're going to make a note out to the side of the spaces that we have to the right of our decimal. And remember, when we get to our second number, we need to put a zero in as a placeholder. So remember, we have three decimal spaces, so we're going to move three times to the left when we complete our problem. And then I'm just going to rewrite the problem. Next, you're going to write dividing decimals, and then write Okay, you need to write dividing decimals. Underneath, I want you to write dividend. Draw a line underneath that and write divisor. Then right across from it, I want you to write divisor. Dividend. And then on top, you're going to write quotient. Now you're going to write steps. Step one, the divisor cannot have a decimal. So move the divisor decimal so that it is a whole number. The divisor cannot have a decimal. So move the divisor decimal so that it is a whole number. Step two, move the decimal and the dividend the same amount of places. Move the decimal and the dividend the same amount of places. Step three is going to be place a decimal straight up where you write your answer and the quotient. And the last step is going to be divide like normal. And then we are going to work out one example.